We're now going to talk about today 7.1 with the rational functions and rational expressions. So we're now going to go to the rational expressions simplifying. So the first property is not a new property to you. You've used it with fractions before and realize that rational expressions just means that we have a fraction that can include numbers, variables, and it can include any of our algebraic signs of adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing. So the key is if you're using this, you need to realize that we can always cancel if they're like factors. So when we're finished with this chapter, this is a chapter that really most of it y'all have seen before when you've done fractions. But when we start throwing variables in, y'all tend to start confusing the different formats. So I want you to kind of put these into different areas. So the first one would be our multiplication problems. So our multiplication problems, if it's multiplication, you can cancel like factors. But that's really important when I talk about it. I'm talking about factors. So it cannot be in a format that is not a product, because that is what a factor means. So we can't cancel like terms, I guess is what you're wanting to say, for multiplication problems. So I want to clarify here. If I had x over x plus 2, I cannot cross those x's out. So what I will suggest some of you do, because it will keep you from doing that throughout this whole section, is putting that x plus 2, that binomial in the denominator, in parentheses, so that you realize that that is a pair that goes together. To cancel it, I have to have the same x plus 2 in the numerator. They won't do those in the videos from my math lab. This is just a suggestion. They will not mark you wrong in my math lab if you leave those parentheses that are in the denominator. So let's start with number 7. So I need you to first of all realize 7 is different than 8, 9, and 10. 7 only has a monomial divided by a monomial. So again, most of you can do this in your head, but I'm going to show you, you are actually still using this property, because I can rewrite the denominator as 7 times 2. So now it's in factored form, and now those like factors cancel. So I'm okay with you on your tests on a problem like number 7 not showing that step and just getting the k over 2. I understand that you can see that. But when we start factoring them, you are expected to show that you factored them and how did you factor them. So some of you I've seen in the past where you don't show the steps of how you break that middle term up. That's very important. We know that if you use certain sites to help you, they're not going to show those steps. And so that's important for you to show on our paper, showing us how did you decide to factor. So you will find that most of these factoring problems are going to be more straightforward than the chapter 6. So what I mean by that is you can see in the numerator denominator of number 8 that we have leading coefficients of 1. So they are more straightforward. We have a y times y, and we also know there has to be a plus and a minus. The only option for 3 is 3 times 1. So the thing that you have to be careful on is which one is a positive and which one's a negative. To get a positive 2y in the middle, it has to be a positive 3 and a negative 1. You can still do these with the AC method, but make sure you're showing that on your test. The denominator, again, is y and y, and the signs will match because it's a plus 2, matches the middle sign, which is a minus, and the only options there are 2 and 1. If nothing matches, you cannot cancel it, but understand something usually does cancel. So we can cancel like factors now. They have to exactly match. My numerator is left with y plus 3. My denominator is left with y minus 2. If you find yourself wanting to cross these out, this is actually the answer. If you find yourself wanting to try to cross the y's out, then leave the parentheses there. They're not going to mark that wrong in my math lab. It's just an extra tool to help kind of make you realize that we have to keep both of those. Those are binomials and they do not match. So going to number 9, in the numerator, remember, don't forget GCF is really important as your first step. So we can pull out a 3, leaves me with a y plus 3. In the denominator, y plus 3 times y minus 3, difference of squares. We mentioned last chapter, difference of squares was going to pop up a lot because it should be a quick, easy factor for you. So now the like factors cancel. Be careful to bring across on the correct side of the division bar what's left over. So we're left with a 3 in the numerator, a y minus 3 in the denominator. If you find yourself wanting to cross out the 3s, put the parentheses there for yourself. That is my answer. Any of these times, pause it, try to see if you can do it. We mentioned in Chapter 6 that you would also see cubes on Test 3 and on Test 4. So here's an example where you're going to use it. So this is a cube in the numerator. So remember that when we factor, we have a binomial and a trinomial. So it would be 1 plus p. 1 times 1 is 1. We need a p squared to get a p cubed. Multiply the first parentheses together and flip your sign. Same sign, opposite sign, always positive. Denominator, nothing to factor, but I do put it in parentheses so that I see it as a pair. Somebody might ask, should I change the order of this problem? You can. It will not mark you wrong. So if you had rewritten it as p cubed plus 1 over p plus 1, it will still work. So now we look for what matches. The 1 plus p's cancel. I am left with only this piece in the numerator, this trinomial. So we remember we don't ever leave a 1 in the denominator, but be careful. If it's in the denominator, you do have to put a 1 in the placeholder in the numerator. So my answer here is 1 minus p plus p squared. Again, there was a 1 here in the denominator, but we never leave that 1 in the denominator in our answer. So you're going to have a cube on this test. You're going to have problems that you have to factor. So you have to become more confident in factoring. Going to number 11. This problem is on a quiz, similar, on the test as well. And it's kind of one of those problems that the reason why people mess up is they try to do both the numerator and denominator at the same time. Don't do that. Finish the whole numerator and make sure you get a factor. My goal, remember, is 2 factors before I cancel. So make sure you finish the factor by grouping. So I'm going to go ahead and start this, and I'm going to put it above just so you can see. So I have a 3 times x plus y, and I have an r times an x plus y. These match, so we can pull those out using the distributive property, and what is left over goes into the other parentheses. So remember, that's the finished part of the numerator. Same thing in my denominator. Pull out a 5, leaves me with an x plus y. Always bring your first sign down, and we pull out a r, leaves me with an x plus y. If you forgot to change your signs there, you will catch your mistake because they won't match. So my denominator will factor to 5 minus r times x plus y. Super important. You have to finish it. So I'm going to rewrite this down here now, what we got as our answer. So we have a 5 minus r x plus y. This is the only step you can cancel. So I see people trying to cancel on this middle step where they don't haven't finished it. You can't do that. It has to be a product before you can cancel. Remember the rule. Has to be multiplication before you can cancel. So my answer here is 3 plus r over 5 minus r. If you find yourself still wanting to cancel those r's, put it in parentheses. Going to number 12 for this problem. So this section. In the numerator, I cannot factor anything. So I'm going to put a parentheses there. In the denominator, some of y'all are going to jump the gun and go, oh, that's a difference of squares. But notice, this is not a difference of squares. So I cannot factor that denominator. So this one is simplified. On a test, you're never going to have a problem like this. We're not going to throw kind of a trick question at you, but you may have it pop up on homework because the computer generates the problems in that case. So just know that our problems, you will at least be able to do something, but be careful to not jump the gun. Make sure it fits the format for factoring. So the last idea for this section deals with the idea of a negative 1 being used here. When you watch her videos, in the My Math Lab videos, she kind of just magically says this works. I actually think that's not the greatest idea because long term, you aren't going to remember it. You're going to use it incorrectly. So remember what I've always said, put something in descending order, or if you have two different variables, put them in the same order. That's the rule that will help you to do these problems. So if I look at this that I've highlighted in the box, I have an A minus B on the top. In the denominator, I want them to be able to match because that's the only way I can cancel them out. So I'm going to rewrite it as negative A plus B. So all I did was change the order. I then never want a leading coefficient of a negative 1. So I'm going to pull out the negative 1. That changes both of the signs. And now you can see this is why they cancel. That's why it's equal to a negative 1. So can you use what's highlighted directly? Yes. But I can tell you right now, most of you will make mistakes long term trying to just use that shortcut. It takes 2 extra seconds to rewrite it and use that rule we've been using all along. Rewrite them, make sure that the order matches because that's the only way I can cancel out any factors. So going with number 13 now. Numerator is fine, but denominator is not in the correct order. So I rewrote it. I'm going to factor out a negative 1. Now I can cancel like factors because, again, now the y minus 2's match. I end up with a 1 over negative 1, so that's how we get a negative 1. So I want you to remember, a negative 1 just means change your sign, and we never leave a 1 or a negative 1 in the denominator. We always will pull that up to the numerator to write it as a simplified format. So could you have just gone directly and used that property and tell me negative 1 on the test? Yes, but it's probably not going to be that easy on the test. So I need you to understand why does that rule work. So on number 14, I'm going to change my order. And so I want, first of all, to realize you can't use this property directly on number 14 because it's not in that format. They don't exactly match. So using my form always actually will be less steps overall. So now, again, I can't factor anything on the top, but now I'm going to pull out a negative 1 in the denominator, which changes my signs. And now this is a difference of squares. And this is why, remember when I said, y'all, I always say rewrite them and always pull out a negative 1 when you're factoring. This is the reason why. It helps you with a problem like this. Now I can factor the denominator to difference of squares, which means P minus 2, P plus 2. Now that it's in factored form and I have exact factors that match, I can pull them out. This is where you got to be careful. Where is that piece left? It's left in the denominator. We always put a 1 in here in the numerator, and generally we actually pull the negative up on top. Could you write this problem as 1 over a negative 1 times p plus 2? Yes, that would be acceptable as well. But generally we never leave a negative in the denominator like that. We either pull it out in front or we put it on the top. So what I mean by out in front, you could actually have typed it into my math lab like this, where the negative's in front of the whole fraction. I think this is the best one for you to do so you'll make less mistakes. So last problem for this section. This is a problem that's from 0028 as well, and I get a lot of people that get this wrong because they try not to do the steps. So I want you to realize, again, the rule says that I can take a negative and I can move it on the top, or I can take that negative and I can move it on the denominator. So in the numerator or denominator. So that's one option for an equivalent form, but that's not the form that they want. They want you to distribute and get rid of the parentheses. In 0028, we actually had these two forms and the next two. So now you got to distribute it and make a negative 5x plus 1 over x plus 9, and then distribute in the denominator 5x minus 1 over negative x minus 9. That is the answers that they want for these. These are equivalent formats. They want you to distribute the negative when they ask for this problem on the test or on the quiz. And what I need you to realize is you don't distribute the negative on top and bottom. The negative is only in either the numerator or the denominator. And so generally when we're doing problems, we normally put the negative in the numerator when we're doing these problems and to finish them.